second Sunday, we celebrate Easter, the celebration. And we are going to begin this phrase together. I'll say the green and or the red and or the yellow. I can see it now. I can see it yellow. And you all do the white, okay? The Lord is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed.
Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
The peace of the risen Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Amen. Any birthdays? Okay, wonderful. And how about prayers? Any names you would like me to pray with? Yes? Emily? Oh, wow. Okay. Anyone else? Okay. And now we pray together. Coming up, there it is. Let us pray. Oh, gracious God, thank you graciously giving us your dear Son, Jesus. And dear Jesus, thank you for taking upon all your sins and dying. We confess that we have not always followed your Son, and we confess that we have worried. Amen. And now let us stand and sing. Fintan. We'll talk to the children. Two little kids are here. Yay. Oh, and there's another one. Yay. Good to see you all. Welcome. I've heard some of you talk to Jesus or pray to Jesus. Have you done that? Oh, cool. Oh, you do that at home? Oh, cool. Wow. Well, I knew one little boy, and he made this for other boys. Isn't that cool? He did this many years ago, and I thought, well, I asked him if he had any more I could give to you all. And what he does is he keeps these with him in his pockets. So if he ever has a problem, he just holds it tightly, and then he starts to talk to Jesus. And so, if you would like one, you may have it. And here you go.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. He made it like Jesus. So it looks a little different. Yeah, that's kind of cool though. So if you ever want to pray or you're forgetting him, he just grabs it and he says, oh Jesus, thank you. Or he starts praying to Jesus, okay? And now we're going to sing this song. And you're all welcome to sing it. And you guys can stay here and sing if you want. Okay? Or let's sing here together, okay? Amen. And I heard you guys singing. That's so cool. You all have a wonderful day. You can go back to your place now. Thank you. Oh, okay. And now we will hear from Psalm.
Today's psalm is Psalm 113. Praise the Lord. Yes, give praise, O servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord now and forever. Everywhere from east to west, praise the name of the Lord. For the Lord is high above the nations. His glory is higher than the heavens. Who can compare with the Lord our God, who is enthroned on high? He stoops to look down on heaven and under earth. He lifts the poor from the dust and the needy from the garbage dump. He sets them among princes, even the princes of his own people. He gives the childless woman a family, making her a happy mother.
Always. Holy Gospel for today is from John 20, 19 to 31. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, and Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord, and Jesus said to them, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." But Thomas, who was called a twin of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of his nails in his hands and put the finger on the mark of the nails and my hand in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, and Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." And then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see your hands. Reach out your hands and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." And Thomas answered him, "My Lord, my God." And Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you see me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet come to believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in the book. But these are written so that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing you will have life in his name. Let us pray. Oh, gracious God, thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus. And may we follow him as you have invited each of us to do so. In your name we pray. Amen. It is wonderful to see that Jesus came to those disciples, even though they were in this hidden place, and yet he appeared. And of course he said, "Peace be with you." And if we look deeply into the ancient Greek, we hear the word peace is slightly different. It's called ero and en. And ero at that ancient time is called peace. But the other phrase is heart. Peace to your heart. Peace in your heart. And it's amazing to see Jesus also talks about how he breathed in them. He received the Holy Spirit by breathing. And we find that many times in the scripture, there is God breathing and Jesus is breathing and flowing peace and love and hope. And in Genesis chapter 2, perhaps many of you know, Genesis chapter 2, we learn that God is creating the very first person, and then he breathes into Adam, and Adam stands up and lives. And we find in many scriptures, Jesus breathes into all of us, and then the Holy Spirit fills us. For example, in Romans and Colossians, it says, "Let the peace of Christ fill your heart." Peace be with each. And one of the things about being here at your church, I have heard and seen and heard from some of the pastors in the past, how you have reached out to people in gracious love and care. And he once told me that it was amazing how some people had become members of the church because you reached out to them in love and care. And I wonder if any of you have had a time where you shared people and you found out that they started to become more of a Christian, or they started to become more involved in a church. Anyone have anything that you've shared that with people? Or expressed? Yes? Sense, yeah, wow. Anyone else have an opportunity to share faith or say to someone you're praying for them? Yes? Uh-huh. Oh, wow. That's cool. Nice, yeah. Years and years ago, when I worked in Minnesota at a church for 15 years, it was wonderful. One day a man came in on a Monday and he said, "Can you talk to me?" I said, "Certainly." And he asked, "Well, what about Jesus or God?" Or he didn't know anything about it. It was amazing. He had been a homeless person for most of his life and he didn't know much about faith at all. And so I shared with him. And then all of a sudden he said, "Can I tell you what horrible thing I did?" And I invited him to confess to God. I said, "We're going to kneel down and you can confess and you will know that Jesus will forgive you, because Jesus chose to take all of our sins upon him, and then he died and God raised Jesus up. So we are all forgiven." And so he and I knelt down and he began to confess a horrible, scary thing. But I did believe that he is forgiven through Jesus Christ. And he changed amazingly. He reached out to people, he started working, and he found food, and he would give them to other people that he knew were homeless. And then all of a sudden, a lawyer called me and said, "You're going to have to go to the place and you're going to have to tell the story about what he did." And I said, "Well, I'm a pastor. I don't tell people what they did. I believe they are forgiven." And they said, "You still have to come." So I went. And it was so amazing. When that boy came, he said, "I do want to confess and tell you all what I did, and I feel horrible that I did it, and I'm sure I'll go to jail, and that's okay, but I do believe God has forgiven me, and I won't do anything like that again." And to me, that was just so amazing that he accepted Christ in such this amazing way. And he was fully forgiven, and after about 8 years, he asked me, "Can I go somewhere and learn more about God?" And that was joyful to share with him, a school he could go learn about faith. And he also became a member of our church. It was amazing. And to me, that is what part of this scripture is about, talking to Thomas. That Jesus did reach out to Thomas, and Thomas then quickly believed and said, "Oh yes, Jesus, you are Lord, you are God." And I know that is what all of you believe, that Jesus is Lord and Jesus is God, and that you all are blessed. Let us pray. Oh gracious God, thank you that you have come to each and every one of us, and that all of us are fully forgiven, and we are invited to be with you eternally. In your holy and gracious name, amen. I think it's a hymn. And now let us pray. And you are invited to pray out loud for someone or something also at this time. Let us pray. Oh, gracious God, thank you for your presence with each and every person. And thank you that you are with Emily. Please help her to become healthy sooner. And if anyone else wants to pray, you're allowed. Holy and gracious God, we thank you that you are present with each and every one of us, and that you have invited us to pray for people who are struggling. We ask for each person that you are with them, and please guide us how we can share with them and bless them. And holy God, thank you that this church so dearly gathers together in such love and peace. In your holy and precious name we pray, amen. And now let us share peace with one another. The peace, the Lord be with you. Gracious God, thank you for this wonderful gift, and may you guide each us in your exact way. In your holy name we pray. Amen. And now we will begin Holy Communion. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He broke it, and he gave it to all. Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And again after supper, he took the cup, and he gave it to all. And he said, this cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of all sin. Do this in remembrance of me. Amen. And you may all come forward. There's this bread and the little ones here, and then the wine and also the non-wine ones. And you may come forward. If you would like, and if you need us to come to you, please do. Hi.
Hi.
Oh, you're helping? They're helping. Oh, cool. You know what to do? You got over here. Oh, cool. Great. We start on this side, right? Given for you. The body of Christ given for you, dear. The body of Christ given for you.
Shed for you.
The body of Christ given for you. last announcement? Anyone have an announcement? Yes? A couple. Yay. May the Lord bless you and keep you each and every moment. Amen. And now we're going to sing. peace of Christ is with you all. Go in peace. Amen.